Tennessee Williams is an American literary icon. His works are still being produced around the world. I'm Dennis Beaver, the curator and the producer for the Tennessee Williams Key West exhibit. He owned a home here. He actually produced many of his works here. He continued to produce poetry and his paintings right up until his death. There's a whole section in this exhibit of playbills from all over Europe where his great works, the most common ones, Streetcar Named Desire and Night of the Iguana, are still being produced. He touched on very sensitive subjects in every play. Even his poetry, much of it couldn't even be produced, published until after his death, because he was very sensitive and very telling it like it was. He would come back from his trips to Paris and Italy and come here to get away from the paparazzi and the press. And he would just sometimes doodle, and he would rewrite plays, rewrite. And so he finished many plays, even though other cities or places say he wrote so-and-so here, he really finished it in Key West. His involvement in our community went everywhere, from sitting at beach cafes and writing poetry to doing fundraisers for the Waterfront Theater or the very first big fundraiser for the Monroe County Library. It started out just as a celebration of his 100th birthday in 2011. And the response was so phenomenal, we just kept expanding the exhibit to move it into this permanent, semi-permanent home. I hope it's permanent. 2 years ago. And we have everything from one of the two typewriters that he used while he was living in Key West. We have photographs of the grand opening and groundbreaking of the Tennessee Williams Fine Arts Center, which is a theater that he funded near the junior college. We have, we have a small collection of giclées of his paintings that he was notorious for. He would sit down and paint a, what we would call a hostess gift in an hour or two, and sometimes they'd still be wet when he took it to his dinner party. So we have a little bit of everything here. The collection grows because people want to continue Tennessee Williams' legacy. They want Tennessee Williams to be visible and noted for what he has done. We just received recently some photographs of Tennessee Williams at a restaurant that's no longer in existence. But you never know where something like that's gonna come from. So we're very happy to receive those type of things. He lived just a few blocks off Duval in a quiet residential neighborhood. When he bought the house back in 1949, it was a very quiet neighborhood. There was hardly anything around there. Actually, he chose that location also to film The Rose Tattoo, which was filmed in the house right next door to his. Because Key West is a very international city, between cruise ships and people from South America and Europe coming into Miami, we're an easy one-day jump off. And it's amazing how many Europeans do come in and say, oh, we've seen this play or that play that has never even been produced on an American stage. March is his birthday, and that tends to be a very good time, especially for the locals, because it's just near the end of our busy tourist season, and we still have time for the tourists to come down from Miami and other places. So we do usually have a poetry contest, a short essay contest, short story contest, and even a painter's challenge, where local artists sign up and go and paint his home or a subject matter, you know, close to Tennessee Williams. I keep saying we, because I feel like Tennessee is with us here all the time. No, we do not have a Tennessee Williams lookalike, but there's enough other things that we can stay busy. Key West is a very party town, and there's a lot to do.